Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading Scripture of St. Martin, Volume 2, which I found right here in the Cathedral of St. Martin. The Scripture of St. Martin, Volume 2, Teachings of the Church, a text written on behalf of the Church of St. Martin by High Priest Nerimus Agrician. Forward. I bid you humble welcome, dear reader, to the second and final volume of the Scripture of St. Martin. The Scripture of St. Martin is divided into two distinct volumes, Volume 1, The Life of St. Martin, and Volume 2, Teachings of the Church. I bid you study each of these separate portions of the text carefully to aid you in the spiritual journey upon which you are about to embark. This, the second volume, is critically important as it enables the reader to explore the lessons that can be learned from the life of St. Martin, described in the previous volume, and how they might apply to their own lives. I thank and commend you for your interest in the teachings of St. Martin. High Priest Nerimus Agrician. The Sainthood of Martin Septim. The key reasons for Martin Septim's sainthood are founded in his rise from humble beginnings to sainthood, and are manifest as so in his three qualities. The first quality, turning from the dark path of Daedra worship to the noble path of serving the divines. The second quality, embarking upon a great and terrible quest for the good of the world. The third quality, selflessness and self-sacrifice. St. Martin's lessons in everyday life. The teachings of the Church of St. Martin are many, yet they are also three, for they are founded in the principle of embodying his three qualities. Translated from the phrasing specific to Martin Septim's personal accomplishments, they become our three qualities that we must strive to achieve, and they are thus. The first quality, self-improvement, rising from low to high status, turning away from dark paths in favor of pure paths. The second quality, boldness and bravery, willingness and ability to act to make genuine, positive change for yourself, for those around you, and for the good of all. The third quality, the primary quality, finds a place unchanged in both his three qualities and our three qualities that we must strive to achieve, and once again, it is thus. The third quality, selflessness and self-sacrifice. The lessons that can be derived from our three qualities that we must strive to achieve are innumerable and ever-changing. They are also near formless and deeply malleable, for they change shape in their application to different circumstances, problems, and indeed, different children of the flock. They might mean abandoning vile and wicked worship and turning to the true divines. They may mean rising to the needs of your local community, or they may mean rising from a life of poverty to a life of comfort. This is the power of St. Martin and his holy word. Yet the importance of balancing these various qualities must not be understated, for each of these qualities may become vile when taken to excess and left unbalanced by other qualities. For instance, the first quality, when employed in rising from poverty to wealth, may transform its wielder, without the third quality, into a greedy, gluttonous, and selfish cretin, unaware and uncaring of the plight of those below them, and unwilling to contribute to the society within which they reside. It is within this balance that the most challenging portion of the teachings of the Church of Martin Septim are to be found. However, I trust that you, dear reader, are up to the challenge, and it is upon these teachings that I leave you to consider how they might best apply to your life and your situation. For further information, I encourage you to meet with me at the Cathedral of St. Martin within the city of Bruma. For I remain Nerimus Agrician, the High Priest of the Church of St. Martin. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, Scripture of St. Martin, Volume 2.